Ahoy! Which one is right for you? DJ Osmo Mobile 3 vlogging setup or kit, or Zhiyun Smooth 4 vlogging setup or kit? They're both excellent, they are very good, everything and all that, but at the same time they're very different. Which one is right for you? If you are new here, welcome. My name is Zdenka Rawla. I create photo and video tutorials, tech reviews, and creative camera challenges. So if that's something you're passionate about, consider subscribing. This gimbal, DJI Osmo Mobile 3, I bought myself. This Zhiyun Smooth 4 gimbal was sent to me by Moment, which make these amazing, beautiful, yummy smartphone lenses. And I was studying those gimbals for a week, playing with them, trying to figure them out, almost took them apart. I wanted to find out which one would be better for me. And then I started thinking about you. Which one would I recommend to you? Which one is better for you? We are all different, have different filming styles, different expectations. Some of you are far advanced, others are beginners. We are simply all so different. All these products here are excellent, they are good, there's nothing really bad here. You need to pick though, which one will work for you. So here are all the differences between those two gimbals, between those two gimbal filming kits and setups. Here's what I think. Let's start with my phone. It's Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. It's not a light phone, it's not a small phone, it's a pretty big one and it's quite heavy. Both gimbals have no problem fitting and balancing my phone. What I like on Osmo 3 is that the ports are not covered like on Smooth 4. The design is simply different. I find the balancing process pretty much the same and easy with both. DJI Osmo Mobile 3 is a smaller gimbal which can fold, so it is way easier to carry around. The downside to this gimbal is the fact that the motors are not super strong. So if you want to use heavy lenses, I do have lens here, it's not the heaviest one, it's quite heavy though. Then you will hear little vibration sounds coming up from the motors. That means that the setup is way too heavy and you're working the gimbal way too hard. I don't know what it's gonna do to those motors down the road. I hear it a tiny bit too with this anamorphic lens. On the other hand, because the ports are not covered, I can easily attach external microphone if I want to. Let's look at the other gimbal. Balancing is very easy as well. Unfortunately, here the ports are covered, so I cannot attach external microphone. Even if I move the microphone a bit to the left, still making sure it is balanced properly. The only way I could add the microphone is if I would use some sort of a counterweight, so I could move the phone even further left. This gimbal has very strong motors. It reacts very fast, it has no problems working my phone. And it doesn't have any problem even adding extra lenses. I just add Moment counterweight, move the phone to the left to balance it properly. If you see how far I moved it, I could even add heavier phone, no problem. Now that the phone is moved, I could also add a microphone if I wanted to film myself here and there. The downside to this gimbal though is that it doesn't fold and is bigger. It might be a bit harder to carry around. Let's turn on both gimbals on and let's see what the differences are when it comes to operating them. Zhiyun Smooth 4 has many buttons, doesn't have a joystick, has this wheel where you can adjust all parameters, zoom or focus wheel and trigger. It's definitely a lot more complicated. It takes a while to figure everything out. I was playing with it the whole evening too, to fully understand it, to figure out everything here. I gotta say, if you are very advanced in filmmaking, or if you love technology, or if you are a computer nerd and just like to dig into things, then you might definitely enjoy this one. The one thing I gotta say though, I'm missing the joystick here. Sometimes I like to adjust the frame or the smartphone just with the push of a joystick. It's not here, it's missing. It simply feels different to work this gimbal. Let's look at the apps. DJI Osmo Mobile 3 has DJI Mimo app. I am Android user. Apple users get access to more stuff. Android is unfortunately limited here. The app is quite easy to use. You can switch gimbal modes here, follow, tilt lock, FPV, sports mode, and locked. You can lock the brightness, do object tracking, use gesture control, create time lapses, motion lapses, take panorama photos, and create stories. If you want to film with the very wide angle lens or in slow motion, you have to get out of the DJI Mimo app and film in a regular camera app. Let's look at the Zhiyun Smooth 4. This gimbal uses ZY app. You can shoot manually or in auto. You can film in pan follow mode, lock mode, full follow mode, and phone go full speed follow mode or sports mode. You can do photos, videos, slow motion, time lapse, motion lapse, vertigo effect, and panorama. You can control focus with focus wheel, log brightness, or use object tracking. Let's talk about Filmic Pro app, since a lot of people love to use Filmic Pro app. DJI Osmo Mobile 3 gimbal, as of right now, is not compatible with Filmic Pro app. You can still use it. You can film with it even when you have your phone on this gimbal, but you will have to tap with your finger to control the app. DJI Osmo Mobile 1 and Osmo Mobile 2 is compatible with a Filmic Pro. And it was not like that at the beginning either. They waited for a little bit until it was less glitchy, like this one right now, and then Filmic Pro made it compatible. Zhiyun Smooth 4, on the other hand, is fully compatible with Filmic Pro and also Moment anamorphic lens, so you can all connect it together and simply enjoy. So, do you want just easy filming, or do you want to control everything? Do you want to shoot manually? Do you want something light and compact, or you don't really care about that? Are you gonna be using external lenses, some of the heavy lenses? Let me know in the comment section below which one is right for you and why. I would be very interested in hearing that. Links to those gimbals and all the accessories I was showing in this video is listed in the video description below, just below the video. Hit the thumbs up button if you liked today's video, subscribe to more, and I'll see all of you, my friends, in the next one. Ciao, ahoy.